The House Investigative Committee on the Robb Elementary shooting releasing its interim report on Sunday, along with video from the school's hallway in the more than 75 minutes before officers breached the classroom where the gunman was shooting, along with body camera video from other officers outside the school.
I'm not surprised by today's findings.
The report found that before the shooter even showed up, the school was ill-prepared for an armed intruder. From a fence that wasn't high enough to bad Wi-Fi that hampered sending out alerts. Michael Matranga, who handled a counterterrorism team for the Secret Service, says it boils down to a lack of situational awareness.
When you close a door behind you, you have to be consciously aware that that door closed. Did it close? Did it not lock? Is it faulty? Did it break? And someone needs to resolve it right now. Because something as simple as an open door may mean the difference between 21 lives lost or saved. And so everyone is responsible.
The report also finding Uvalde CISD police officer Pete Arredondo failed to do his duty as commander, according to his own active shooter plan, and that his lack of leadership may have contributed to the loss of life.
I think that it shows that he was not qualified to be the chief of police.
The report concludes police should have breached the classroom rather than deeming the shooter a barricaded subject. Newly released hallway video shows officers waited for more than an hour, even though the gunman fired more than 100 rounds in the first few minutes, something those officers apparently knew. The report calling Arredondo's delay unacceptable.
For him to say that he was dealing with a barricaded subject, yeah, you were. You were dealing with a barricaded subject, but you were also dealing with an individual who was in a classroom with students and staff, killing them, firing rounds. It is your job as the incident commander and as the chief of police to make that decision to go in there and end that person's life violently to preserve others. There is a certain level of risk that you have to take, and he failed to do it.
The report also finding communication was a disaster. The school failed to lock down quickly, despite 911 calls indicating the shooter was approaching. After the gunfire began, officers inside the school were not informed students and teachers were alive and critically injured in the classroom with the gunman. Lawmakers also faulting outside agencies who arrived later for not taking over command from Arredondo, who shockingly had left his radio behind on the ground.
Communications and technology had a big part to play in this. Shame on him for not having his radio on him. You know, if you don't have anything else, you got to have a means to communicate.
The report concluding many failures stemmed from poor training. Matranga says he hopes making all this public will spark new legislation to truly make schools safer.
What I would like to see moving forward is a standard approach throughout the state in everything from law enforcement response, law enforcement training, selection of those who are tasked with providing security for our staff and our students.
Now, in the wake of the missed warning signs about the Uvalde gunman, Matranga says schools and police need to be more proactive when it comes to suspicious behavior. He says those agencies must actively monitor that behavior and be proactive so what happened at Robb Elementary doesn't happen again.